Just because you're spending more time at home doesn't mean you shouldn't be spending ample time on your skin. Today, we're here with celebrity makeup artist and beauty expert Michelle Phillips to teach us the perfect at-home facial. Hi, Michelle.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Thank you so much for being with us. This is such an important topic. I know, as we talked before, I had been struggling with my skin at the beginning of quarantine, and the importance of a routine and the right products are so important. So we're going to dive right in because I know you have so many neat things to share with us. And you mentioned that the first and most important part of this is really the aspect of cleansing, doing it correctly and using the right products. So tell us about that.
Yes, healthy skin begins with clean skin. And what I really stress for people is that you make sure that you're using a gentle cleanser. And this is my personal cleanser. This is by Arbonne. And Arbonne is one of my favorite product lines because it's free of chemicals and toxins, and it's vegan and plant-based. And this is a gentle cleanser. It's called the RE9 Advanced Smoothing Facial Cleanser. And I love this because it's good for all skin types to really remove the impurities, the dirt, and the makeup from your skin. But again, I stress it's gentle because a lot of people make the mistake of really using harsher cleansers that really strip your skin. And when you do that, you can create more acne, more irritating, results from your skin. So always stick with a gentle cleanser.
And in addition to cleansing, we all have to realize that exfoliation and the process of really getting into the pores is so critical as well. What sort of products should we be considering for our skin to make sure, like your cleanser, that it's not too rough, but also effective?
So true. Now, this is such a good point that you make because typically people, when they think of exfoliants, they get like the scrubs that are sold out there. And you'll typically find those in like drugstores where it's like an apricot scrub. And you'll find that the granules are very sharp. You want something that is like a smooth, almost sphere kind of feel to it, a soft, gentle. So when you are exfoliating your skin, it's gently exfoliating. Otherwise, you can really cause a lot of damage. And the reason that we exfoliate is because the exfoliation process of our skin naturally slows down as we age. And therefore, you'll get more and more buildup on the top of your skin. And there, when you're adding your moisturizers or your serums and your treatments, it's not going to actually penetrate your skin. It's just going to sit on the top of the dead skin. So you want to make sure that you exfoliate a couple times a week. Again, gently is the key to just softly remove any dead skin. And then just keep it simple.
That's right. Keeping it simple is really the key for making sure that we can maintain this process, especially doing it multiple times a week. I know there have been times where I've got all these different products and I kind of get stuck on which ones to use when. So that's great feedback. Now, you mentioned something that I don't typically do, which is steaming. So what is that process like? And I would imagine it can get a little warm. How do we do that safely?
Yes, safely is what I do is just take a washcloth and immerse it in warm water or kind of a little hotter, warm water. Squeeze it out completely and then let this lay on your face for, a minute or so. And the reason for this is just to open up your pores, remove any residue that may be remaining on your skin. So then you can move into the next step, which would be to create, to start using a treatment. You can use a mask, something like a moisturizing mask. This one is great. This is by Is Clinical. It's a hydra intensive cooling mask that gives you a deep quench of moisture to your skin. You apply for like 20 minutes. It really hydrates and boosts your skin. Another one is Drunk Elephant if you want something to detoxify your skin. If you have more breakouts, you want to really get that glow. This is the Baby Facial, which has the alpha hydroxy acids in it. And then you are ready to prep your skin for the moisturizer after that to really hydrate your skin. And that is the last step.
So moisturizing. Now, yes. For me, I typically have chosen the wrong things because I feel like, oh, I've got oil here or a combination there. So I want something less moisturizing. But moisturizing is important no matter the skin type.
Yes. And, you know, this is such a good point, again, that you bring up. A lot of people think if they have oily skin or problematic skin, like such as breakouts, that they should not use a moisturizer. And the exact opposite is true. I love the Olay Regenerous Microsculpting Cream. And the reason I share this is, A, you can get it in the drugstore. B, the Olay Red Jar line, I've been using for years. I absolutely love it. I use it. My daughter uses it. My mom uses it. So all different types of skin types. And it is lightweight, absorbs into your skin, provides long-lasting hydration, plumps the skin, and actually softens the look of fine lines and wrinkles because it has like vitamin B3, it has amino peptides, things that really plump up the skin and provide hydration. Because what you want to really think about is that the more you moisturize and hydrate your skin, the more you're healthy your skin will become. A lot of times people think that stripping their skin, you know, abrasive exfoliants, and then skipping the moisturization product will help their skin, you know, dry up, clear up. But that is not true. When my kids had acne growing up, I put them on more gentle and hydrating products and used the alpha hydroxy acids to actually help keep their pores clean. And that really helped. So the point is to not make your face a science project, you know, be careful, start off gentle and get products that are, like I said, simple so that you can really start to see a difference. Cause whatever's going on internally will show up externally. No matter what our age, we're going to have problematic skin.
That's right. And all of those tips are so helpful, especially as we think about teenagers and the younger members of our family. It really starts at the beginning. Thank you so much for being with us. We have so much to think about, so much to start doing if we haven't been already, and we so appreciate it.
Thank you.
For those of you interested in doing your own at-home facial, make sure you visit our website, wtvr.com/BTM.
Great insights. And I'm now thinking about that steaming washcloth for later this evening, just kind of relaxing a little bit and getting things cleared out.